Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Today we got a little scanner guys made by Altair to review for you and see how it works. Okay, it's this one right here. That's what we got. You know, that's the company that we use for our big professional scanner. But what we like about those little ones are they're handy. You can take them with you anywhere. You can see that's the description of it. So let's go ahead and open and see what's inside. Usually they come with a real nice bag. Okay, let's see if that's the case now. Yep, real nice heavy duty bag. And let's open inside and see what we have here. Okay, we have the OBD reader here. We have the manuals, more manuals, CD. Okay, that's great, user manual. Here we have the OBD cable and we should have a USB cable. Okay, so let's go ahead and open it and see how that thing works, guys. We have an engine light on that Mercedes here. That's a 2003 E320 Mercedes. So we're just going to go ahead and install the cable now. Just connect it right here, you can see. And always make sure that you use those twisty things. I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about, because if you don't, guys, sometimes you're in the middle of diagnostics, you might lose communication, and sometimes it's not good for the computers to do that. Okay, so let me start the car quick, guys, to show you how we have the engine light on. We'll try to read it, see what's wrong, and see if we can fix it. Okay. So if I start the vehicle now, okay, check engine light on. Okay, so you can see that's not good. So this is the scanner here now, guys. Okay, so this one, what I like about it, okay, you don't even need to read the manual. Most of the times they're so easy to use. You have oil white reset as well on this one. So if you go to OBD, okay, and all you have to do, click OK. It's going to connect link to the vehicle now. Okay, it's going to take a little bit of time to communicate with the computers. It's going to find the right protocol that it's going to use for this Mercedes. And that should work on any vehicle that has the OBD port after 1996. Okay, it's almost ready, right there. Codes found, we have one. You see, it monitored six things and it seems like it's okay, and three incomplete. This is for emissions, guys. You have to drive so many miles to make sure that the computers are ready for emissions. So now we're going to click OK. Okay, and we can go ahead and read the codes. Okay, stored codes now. Cylinder number 3 misfire detected. Okay, it costs for $10. It's gonna give you even a thing. In my opinion, if it's a spark plug, it has a double spark plug, that Mercedes will show you. It will be $10. If it's ignition coil, second hand, again, it's about $10. That's the code. Okay. And now, all you need to do, click escape to go back. Let's see if we have any pending codes. Okay, no pending codes. So, what we're going to do now, guys? Okay, let's go check and see what's happening there, because it looks like usually the code that starts with P03012345 6, that's ignition coil. So we're going to remove the engine cover quick. Okay, and see what we have there. Okay, ignition coil is there. Let me show you. Okay, this one right here, and it looks like this wire got loose. Check it out. it doesn't contact good. So you gotta make sure that you push it all the way in. Sometimes people, this one was replaced. Because as you can see, it should have a zip tie here holding the cable, and it has that seal. And whoever did it, they didn't push it all the way in. They left it like that. Well, from vibrations and driving down the road, it came loose. So we're going to go ahead, push it in all the way until it clicks. Install the engine cover, okay? And I'm going to go ahead and attempt to delete the code now inside. Okay, let's see if that little scanner will do that for us. And I'm gonna show you what else you can do with it, guys. Stay with us. Okay, we'll have the link in the description of the video for the product. Okay, let's go ahead and erase the code. Select erase codes. Okay, are you sure? We say yes. Erase done. Press any key to continue. So, let's go ahead and start it now and see what's happening there. And no engine light, guys. No engine light. But let me show you what else you can do with that thing, which could be very powerful too when you're doing diagnostics. You can go down to live data right here. And when you do that, you can check all the different things about your vehicle. Okay, I'm gonna show you. You're going to see spark advance. You're going to see if the mass airflow sensor works, throttle position, all that stuff. Okay, we're going to complete list now. And okay, you can check the vehicle load capacity. If I give it gas, it'll go up. Okay, the temperature 104 right there of the coolant. Okay, so we can go down. Okay, map, you can see the map sensor. Okay, that works. RPMs. Okay, goes up. It's very responsive. Spark advance. Okay, you can check all that stuff. Okay, and that's the map sensor right here. It works too. Okay, so everything looks pretty good. That's what I like about live data. You can see a lot about your engine. Okay, and when you do that, okay, you can diagnose what's wrong with it. This one, for this specific vehicle, does not support the oxygen sensor test, but on some vehicles it does. So let's go ahead and try to reset the oil light now. Okay, and we're going to select Mercedes now. Press any key to continue. Okay, and you can see that you can download one vehicle for free. Please connect your device to the PC. You will need to download the procedure for the Mercedes oil reset or whatever your vehicle is. You can change languages, you can do LCD test, key set, and all that stuff. So, pretty cool too, guys. Definitely recommend it. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.